have discussed lesson, the portrait of a lady by Pushpant Singh in previous video. We have completed discussion part. Today we will discuss question answers. So here understanding the text. Question number first. The three phases of author's relationship with his grandmother before he left the country to study abroad. We have discussed all three stages in detail. For the sake of question again, I will refer that three stages. First phase, what is the first phase here? The first phase is about village life, and in that village life, how grandmother was doing her all the tasks, or how was the routine of the grandmother, and how it is described in that passage, we have to write in short. Page number first. So what things you will highlight? You will highlight the line number first. How was the friendship? Good friends. So see, I will refer that line for you. Like that, the lines you have, my grandmother and I were good friends. So this line is important in answer. Because in first phase, second phase, third phase, that friendship, it is changing. The relationship or that bond of the friendship was different. In different phases, the bond of the friendship, it is differently described. So each phase is important. So in first phase, what you will mention about their friendship, then routine, it's how she used to prepare author for the school, then about the prayer, about breakfast, then about the stale chapatis, how she used to give to the village dogs, then prayer in the temple, reading of the scriptures in the temple, and then the company of the grandson while going also, then after school also the same company, and she used to enjoy all that task. And you can also focus that she was also expecting from the author that he should also by heart the prayers. Here he used to do all that things because author loved the voice and author used to respect the grandmother. So this is the first phase. Now in the second phase, what answer you will write? There is one word, that is turning point. That I will refer for you. That was a turning point in our friendship. What was that turning point? Here you will mention. So you can mention, when my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. Means when parents called both, means grandmother and the author in the city, and that was the turning point in their friendship. And what happened in the second phase? New school, especially English school, there is one common thing, that is they were sharing the room. But two opportunities grandmother used to get, that is she used to go with the grandson, means by walking to the school. Now near a school bus, so she cannot go with the author. One more thing, again while come back also, school bus facility it is there. Then There was a difference in their philosophy, prejudices about the modern education. Here she was not thinking in modern way. She was not accepting the modern education system, and she was thinking, means her philosophically religious views, if we will think, then she was expecting that the education should be on the moral base, about the God, scriptures. But here in modern thing, more about the science, music, so many things. Author used to learn in that English school. But here some prejudices about the music also, it is mentioned that it is the monopoly of harlots and beggars. So the two words you can understand. And from that time, she was rarely speaking with the author. This is the second phase. Then in the third phase, university education. And author had given the new room. So the common thing it was, she was sharing the room in the second phase, but in third phase what happened? Now room is also not same. Means the communication again got widened. And in this phase, grandmother's behavior we can observe, it is totally changed. So what is the change in the behavior of the grandmother you can notice? So change here we can notice, that is the, she was sitting in that spinning wheel from morning, means sunrise to sunset, and only one thing there was the happiest moment, half an hour, that is, here we can mention, half hour. It would be the happiest half hour of the day for her, and that was the feeding the sparrows. So in the third phase, what is the behavioral change we are here observing or notifying, that is, she was in depression. She was feeling the problem of loneliness, alienation. Here, grandson is not there for communication because of the university education. And she was involved herself in the prayer. So more preference it is for the prayer, and the second preference she used to give for the feeding the sparrows. And here one more thing it is noticed in the second phase. When we are thinking about second phase, at least rarely means he was speaking, but in the third phase when we are observing, all atmosphere changed. Means her behavior started changing. So before going to the abroad, all three phases of the here stages or phases we can mention, it is important to know, then only the next behavior we can notice. So here in short you have to write the three reasons why the author's grandmother was disturbed when he started going to the city school. So now what are the three things here disturb? So one thing here we can say that she was not getting the company of the grandson, means the school bus, new environment, also we can here focus. Then one more thing here, this was her unhappy state of mind. The reason here mentioned that Western science, then learning of the law of gravity, Archimedic principles, and the world is being round, all that things here author shared. But she was unhappy to listen that. And then one more thing here it is noticed, that English school, in that English school, what they used to teach, but here expectation of the grandmother was different. What she was expecting here means she was displeased that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. This also point we can mention. Then she was again thinking, means there was a prejudice about the music. And what is that prejudice? Here we can observe, that is, one day I announced that we were being given music lesson. She was very disturbed. Again, this is one of the cause of the disturbance. And why she was disturbed, the reason is afterwards given. Here, to her, music had lewd association. It was the monopoly of harlots and beggars and not made for gentle folk. So she was thinking it is not the meant for the gentle folk. It is only for the harlots and beggars. So at least three reasons you can mention in this answer. So question, it is easy. Then third question, three ways in which author's grandmother spent her days after the dream of. So three ways means, the first thing we can observe here, that evening grew up means after childhood age we can mention. So especially in the second phase, what would be her routine? The routine would be just from this morning, at least she could take the benefit that at least in the second phase, grandmother and the author, they were sharing the room. So she could help me to pack up all that things. But in the third phase, in university education, the question is asked, three ways in which the author's grandmother spent her days after the grief of. So in that, the one thing it is, because of the rare communication, from morning, sunrise to sunset, she used to see in that spinning wheel. And what was her important task? She was involved in the prayer. And then one more routine, that is, she used to feed the sparrows, and that was the half hour, and that was mentioned as a happiest hour. So two, three things here we can mention. In that specially two things you have to mention in the routine, that is, she used to sit on that spinning wheel from morning, sunrise to sunset, evening up till evening. Then the second task, she used to pray, means the bits of the prayer she used to do. Then half hour she used to spend with the sparrows, to feed the sparrows, and that was the happiest thing. And the rest of the routine. So no more things here, no more schedule it is given about grandmother. Then the odd way in which the author's grandmother behaved just before she died. So what is the odd way? So odd way here means, what was the very important common link? It was there in the grandmother. That common link was, she used to pray. Means when she was in loneliness, she was always praying. So inaudible, some words are also here mentioned, that her routine was, she has given more preference to the prayer. But what was the odd behavior here? She stopped that prayer. I will refer that line for you. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. Means before the death, this is the clear signal we can understand. So here, odd way, and one more thing, means she stopped praying, and they tried to persuade her to stop that overstraining which he was doing the pendulum of that drumming, all that things. But the thing is here, they were persuading her, but she didn't listen. One more thing, there was a mild favor. But then also, one means she was good lady, religious lady. But what is her expression about that? She told us that her end was near. She said that since only few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray. So this is, she omitted to pray means she stopped that praying, and that was the, again, one more important thing here, author is noticing. So this is the odd way she had followed. Then one more here, she was not going to waste any more time talking to us. So this is also one of the behavior, means he was not thinking that there is arrival of the grandson, at least she should enjoy with the grandson, but there is no any change in her behavior. So this odd behavior you can mention. Then the way in which sparrows express their sorrow when the author's grandmother died. So last passage, all these expressions are used, and means how animals, birds, they are also showing their emotions, feelings, if they are attached to some. You can also observe such type of behavior with the dogs or cat or other also animals. When you have that bond if it is created, then that animal, if you are not there, or when you will go home, if you have that attachment or bond with the, some animals, then you can observe their expressions when your arrival is there. If you are not there, then sometimes they may not eat also. So such type of factor here also it is seeking expressed. I will refer that lines for you. You can mention that in your answer. All over the veranda and in her room, right up to where she lay dead, stiff wrapped in the red shroud, thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the door. There were, means there was no chirping. So this is important line, right? There was no chirping. We felt sorry for the birds, and my mother paid some bread for them. So now, if suppose it was the daily routine of the grandmother, so author's mother might have thought that now we will give something to the sparrows and then they will take it and go out. But it was expected, but it didn't happen. So here, one more thing here it is noticed about the sparrows. What is that important thing here? It is mentioned by the author. She broke it into little crumbs, means that breads. The way my grandmother used to and threw it to them, the sparrows took no notice of the bread. So this line here it is important. Earlier one line, that is, there was no chirping, this behavior. Then the sparrows took no notice of the bread, this behavior. And again one more, when we carried my grandmother's corpse off, they flew away quietly. Means without taking that bread crumbs, they flew, and that is again quiet. So this important things, means when you are observing the lines, you can notice the way in which the sparrows express their sorrow when author's grandmother died. three important lines you can refer and you can explain that their bond with the grandmother, how it was. So I feel that no more explanation is required for question number 5. Then talking about the text, in this question number 1, the author's grandmother was a religious person. What are the different ways in which we come to know this? Religious person. So sure she was a religious lady. How we would come to know about this? We will give some instances or examples from beginning to ending of the lesson. So here author provided us more information about grandmother through some lines or through some expressions in the lesson. So we will refer that expression. Passage number 2. In that passage number 2, how was her behavior? So here two lines I will refer. In that line number 1, she was like the winter landscape in the mountains, and expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. So here, how was her behavior? Her behavior was compared with the winter landscape in the mountain. Means she was peaceful, and that tranquility of mind. And how that tranquility of mind or peaceful behavior, calm, freshness, even though she was senior citizen. So author already explained that she was beautiful also. Beautiful means beauty of the mind. So if this is referred, then we can mention that she was the religious lady. And one more thing, in the same passage it is given, she hopped about the house and in spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, and other telling the beads of her rosary. So here other telling the beads of her rosary means she was always involved in the prayer. Then in first page, some examples or instances we can provide. So what are that instances we can provide? Here expectation. What was her expectation? She said her morning prayer in monotonous sing song while she bathed and dressed me, in the hope that I would listen and get to know by it by heart. Means she was expecting that when she will sing that prayers, automatically it would be by heart to the author, and it was expectation. So any a religious person would do that regularly. If it is mechanical, then it would not come regular. So it was the spontaneity in her nature, in her behavior, that she was thinking about the prayer. Then one more thing here, in the same passage we can notice, I listen because I love her voice, but never bother to learn it. So why this here author is mentioning? Because when someone have that passion, that love and pure mind, then everyone can react in a positive way. And that was the love, because her behavior was pure. And that behavior, in good behavior, it is observed in the religious personality. Then in the next passage, we can observe, the grandmother always went to school with me, because the reason is given. What is the reason? The school was attached to the temple. So this also line, it is important here, because the school was attached to the temple. And again one more reference about the reading. So here, what is that reference? My grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. So she used to read that scriptures when author was learning in that village. Then any religious person would have love for the animals. So she used to take that skill, chapatis with her, and she used to give it to village dogs. So that is again one more reference about the religious personality. So it is proved. Then new phase, then dogs were not there, but she observed the sparrows and she used to feed that sparrows regularly. So this is again example of the religious views or the purity of mind and the love for the animal or birds. Then in second phase, third phase also same thing it is described. What is that description? Description is about the her routine. What was her routine in that third phase also? She used to sit in that spinning wheel, and in that spinning wheel from morning, means sunrise to sunset, she used to pray. So that praying was the very important priority, because she was lonely and there was no one to speak with her. Again, one more reference we can give here. As a religious, means her, as a priority, she had changed the priority, and in that priority, to give some important things to the, especially to the sparrows, she used to feed that sparrows, and that half hour, it is mentioned as a happiest hour for her. When she used to take out the time and she used to relax herself in that only time. Otherwise, different things here it is mentioned about the their relationship was not, their friendship was not, and because of that friendship, because of the relationship snap, what happened here? Grandmother was not communicating with any member, especially the grandson. She was not speaking properly. So here when author decided to go for abroad, that time also, means while departure also, her priority was prayer. Means instead of focusing on other things, she focused on the prayer. So this is again the reference. After arrival, after 5 years arrival also, her priority was the prayer. Means she was not thinking about the communication. She was only thinking about the prayer, and her routine was the same thing. Then at the end also, same thing it is given. The ending reference is also very important. And what is that ending reference? She lay peacefully in bed, praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. So this also important thing we can notice. And last, the sparrow's behavior. If she would have treated the sparrows differently, then sparrow's behavior we may not observe. So without taking that breadcrumbs, all that sparrows, they were sitting there, so many sparrows were there, but they were maintaining the pin drop silence. There was no chirping we can observe. So this, because of the her bond, that spiritual bond, that religious bond, it was created in both the, means sparrows and the grandmother. So all that examples, if we will give that instances, we can clearly mention that author's grandmother was a religious person. Then describe the changing relationship between the author and his grandmother? Did their feeling for each other change? So here, describe the changing relationship between author and his grandmother. So we have to explain here phase number one. How was the friendship? How was the relation of the author and the grandmother? It was there in the phase one. So some highlights of the phase one we have to give. In that, we have to mention the line it is given in the passage, my grandmother and I were good friends. So friendship was good in the village or the phase one, village life. All that routine, means he was involved in all that activities of the author, and author was also happy with the grandmother, and there was very nice atmosphere combination and healthy environment, and she was also involved in her own routine, that is go to the temple, read that scriptures or give that chapatis to the dogs. But when in the second phase, that there was a change, and what was that change? New school, city environment, then she was not there with the author, means the company, while going to the school or coming back from the school. So here we can observe that there was a change in their relation, change in their friendship, and that was the turning point, it is also described. And in the second phase itself, because of the prejudice, because of the little bit rigid behavior, we can observe that she was not able to mold herself according to the modern era or modern education or the knowledge which is exist about the science, all so music, and she was thinking with prejudice, and that was what expected. So here, when we are observing about the grandmother, that change means at the end of the second phase, it is said that she rarely talked to me after that. So here, this line clearly noticed, we can observe that through this line, author's relationship or that friendship, it was day by day, the bond of the friendship, it was decreasing. And then in the third phase, due to new again environment, both they were not sharing the room also, the new room, the new atmosphere, and here author used the word that resignation. Now she decided that now nothing will happen, my grandson would not be with me, and then she started thinking negatively, and that was the stage, means it was the starting of her depression, and the main root cause is the loneliness and communication barrier. Her philosophy was different, her religious views were different, her ideas were different. All that ideas, her philosophy, her thinking about the education was different. So she was not able to adjust in that new environment, and that was the root cause of her unhappy state of mind. And in that unhappy state of mind, she was not able to survive, she was not able to cope up, and then she decided that she would not speak with anyone, and she changed her routine, she changed her way of living, and she was always sitting in that spinning wheel from morning, means the sunrise, up till the evening, the sunset, and only that half happiest was the, means to feed the sparrows. So here, how that her relationship, means the question it is asked in that sense, describe the changing relationship between author and his grandmother. So when author decided to go for the abroad, there also same thing, while departure scene also, she was, means she was not that much sentimental, there was nothing in her mind, she was involved in the prayer, after 5 years arrival, also same thing here it is. She was not interested to speak with the author. And then when she decided to give up the life, that time also she was not thinking about any other person in the family, even though they protested, even though they persuaded, even though everyone they requested her to stop the overstraining, but she didn't listen to anyone. And there was very small in the mild favor, but she decided to quit the life. And that everything it happened because of their changing relationship. And she was feeling lonely, and that loneliness finally reached the death of the grandmother. And here next question, did their feelings for each other change? So yes, we can say that their feelings, means the grandson was thinking, but here due to some such type of things happened, means the prejudices, loneliness, or the communication barrier, so many things here, means there was a love, there was a bonding, but that friendship here snapped. Clearly it is mentioned, that is, the common link of friendship was also snapped. So here we can explain in that aspect. Then, would you agree that the author's grandmother was a person strong in character? If yes, few instances that shows this. So here surely we can give the expressions, whatever it is given or the instances given in the lesson. So we can give the reference of the character, that how the character of the grandmother, like a winter landscape. Then her daily routine about the prayer. Then she used to give stealth chapatis to the village dogs. Then she used to feed the sparrows. Then she used to read the holy books. So through all that things, here we can mention that she was the good lady, of the good character. But sometimes, even though you are good, sometimes if you have some prejudices, or if you would not be able to cope up in new environment, if she would be in the village, then what would happen? She may not give up her life, because routine it was not good in the city area, and the loneliness was more, and day by day, means it was not only one day, this every day the same experience for her. And she was not able to cope up in new environment, that city environment. So that was not the negative thing in her strong character. So here positive traits are more, and some in that negative trait we can observe that she was not able to mold herself in new environment. Doesn't mean that she was not having that good character. So here, would you agree that author's grandmother was a person in strong character? So here we will focus that she was surely the strong character lady, and you can give whatever the things concerned with this. And then next question, that have you known someone like author's grandmother? Do you feel the same sense of loss with regard to someone when you have loved and lost? So here you might have such type of experiences, and that experiences you can share to your teachers, your friends. You might have observed, or it may be your friends or nearby neighbors you might have observed. So that experiences, this is personal response question, you can answer. So we have discussed all important questions from this lesson. I hope that you have enjoyed the lesson. Only the thing is, whatever that moral message it is given, that you never give up. In new environment you have to adjust. You should think about each and every environment with positive way, otherwise. Or when someone is in new environment, we have to speak with that person. That person should not feel that he is lonely, and we have to give them that seeing love, respect, their own status we should always give them, and then they would be satisfied in the new environment. And even though if you are somewhere else, nowadays due to different gadgets, means phone, at least you can speak using the phone or other or devices, whatever you have, but never lose your grandparents due to such type of loneliness. So thank